Today, we're going to take a deeper dive into our Magnet Plus connected devices. Magnet Plus devices are versatile options that enable automated bead-based extraction workflows. In this video, we'll address their main features while discussing important considerations, take a closer look at how to use and program them, and discuss example applications. There are so many different magnetic bead-based extraction workflows possible that a one-size-fits-all solution simply doesn't exist. This is why we have three different Magnet Plus devices, each designed for an optimal maximum volume of beads and sample while providing excellent bead capture capabilities. Let's start with the lowest volume Magnet Plus model and work up from there. The 96PCR Magnet Plus device is designed for conical bottom plates with a working volume of about 150 to 200 microliters. The Deepwell Magnet Plus device is the next step up in terms of total volume capacity, and the selection of compatible labware is diverse here, with total working volumes of Deepwell plates ranging anywhere from 700 microliters all the way up to 2 milliliters. After that, we enter a different category of working volumes altogether with the 50ml tube Magnet Plus device, specifically designed for MIDI prep extractions in centrifuge tubes, but more about that later. These Magnet Plus devices each have an automated moving shelf that strategically positions magnets close to the bottom sides of each individual well or tube for pelleting phases. Naturally, this magnetic shelf can be easily programmed to move away from the consumable for resuspension steps. We even have a patent showing that our Magnet Plus devices don't have residual magnetic fields that would negatively impact binding and elution steps. When analyzing which device and labware option is best for your workflow, there are a couple of main parameters to take into consideration. First, what is the maximum volume of your sample and beads combined? Second, what is the minimum volume of elution you want to obtain? The total volume of washing buffer you plan to use is much less critical, as this volume can be separated into several smaller steps. With these parameters identified, another thing to think about is avoiding potential cross-contamination between wells during your plate preparations. If your total volume is dangerously close to the maximum working volume of the consumable, perhaps opting for a deep well plate over a classic PCR-type plate could be beneficial to avoid splashing, for example. However, just be aware that each consumable has dead volume of liquid, for which automated aspiration is really not guaranteed. These dead volumes are made clearly visible directly in OneLab when selecting a labware, so that you can make an informed choice. Now, I'd like for you to think about your current approach when managing bead-based assays. Are they done manually and error-prone? Are you spending a lot of time on a cluttered bench? Magnetic bead extraction workflows are simple, in theory, but they often require many awkwardly interspersed hands-on intervention steps. They are long and tedious and can monopolize precious bench space. Methods like these are a burden for operators for those reasons, but also because particular attention needs to be paid to parameters like bead capture time, avoiding carryover and contaminations, ensuring proper homogenizations, and also maximizing yields. With that in mind, simplifying this overall approach through an intuitive protocol design involving connected devices could greatly reduce this burden. Having a step-by-step breakdown that is simplified and semi-automated avoids the need to remember which step you're on or check to see if your beads have been properly pelleted. It's important to know that our Magnet Plus devices take the fixed labware approach, where instead of transferring solutions to and from different consumables for bead capturing and washing, only one piece of labware is used throughout an entire method. While more pipette tips are required, this does allow for an entire workflow to be done in less total space, and that's particularly automation friendly. While the extraction of DNA is the broad overarching field for which bead-based methods are used, we can highlight a couple main application spaces where these workflows are most prominent. Those are proteomics, with antibody extractions and immunoseparations, for example, and genomics, with applications in NGS, prenatal screening, qPCR, and plasmid purifications. For more inspiration, visit the OneLab Protocol Library to see applications that use the Magnet Plus for great results. Magnet Plus requires no programming knowledge whatsoever and is really easy to implement using the OneLab software. Let me show you. But first things first, though. Let's get connected by pairing Magnet Plus to your workspace. The device pairing process can be done either through Wi-Fi or directly via LAN in a few quick steps. Just follow the software prompts in our quick start guides in the user manuals that you can find right here. Once paired with your lab, the device becomes available in the Devices tab of the software and will automatically be suggested by OneLab during the execution phase of a protocol. Now, let me show you how to create a protocol step that will utilize a Magnet Plus device. Once in the Protocol Designer window of OneLab software, it's important to first select Magnet Plus compatible labware. Any consumable chosen from this filtered list will then trigger the use of the device during the execution phase. The exact device compatibility is also visible in the consumable information window, and you can even check to make sure you have the appropriate device connected to your lab before starting to use it. Next, click on the Actions button on the left panel, select Apply Magnetic Field from the list, drag and drop the consumable you want to apply the action to, and then simply select the desired duration for bead capture. OneLab then generates a two-part step, one for applying the magnetic field and waiting for bead capture, and one for removing the magnetic field afterwards. This two-part step format allows the user to then embed additional actions that will take place once the bead capture time has elapsed, like removing waste. Once your protocol is built, click on Execute, and OneLab software will calculate the best configuration for your method based on the available devices and pipettes, while suggesting different execution options. Choose the option that's most relevant to your current process between a manual run, a guided run with the addition of connected pipettes, or an automated run, and you're good to go. You'll see that a Magnet Plus has been selected thanks to a dedicated icon. So, are you ready to power up your lab? To learn more about Magnet Plus and discover our other connected devices, visit waters.com/AndrewAlliance.